Can a diabetic fast during Ramadan? This is a question commonly asked to doctors during this holy month of Ramadan. And as a medical doctor, it's important to take a objective evaluation to this, rather than a subjective purely based on the fact that they have a chronic disease, despite the healthy aspect of fasting. So in order to take a proper medical stand to this topic, the International Diabetic Federation have collaborated with the Diabetes and Ramadan International Alliance and made some practical guidelines that provide both background and practical information, as well as management recommendations to optimize the care to people with diabetes who wish to fast during Ramadan. That's why I thought, since I'm fasting and it's approximately 2 hours left before I can eat, let me go for a little walk and make a quick video going through the main points of those guidelines on whether a patient with diabetes can fast during Ramadan or not. Fasting during Ramadan is one of the five pillars of Islam, and an obligatory duty for all healthy adult Muslims, excepting the ill and the pregnant woman from fasting. In healthy individuals, the increase in glucose levels after a meal stimulate the insulin secretion, which triggers the storage of glucose as glycogen in liver, muscles, and adipose tissue. When you fast, the circulating glucose levels drop and insulin secretion decreases as well. Normally, you would want to maintain a normal amount of glucose in your blood. And since you're now not eating, the body will secrete glucagon and catecholamines to break down glycogen into glucose. If fasting is prolonged for several hours, glycogen reserves drop, and the low circulating insulin levels allow the release of free fatty acids from the adipocytes. So the oxygenation of free fatty acids generate the ketones that serves as an energy source for skeletal and cardiac muscles, liver, kidney, and adipose tissue, thus saving glucose for continued use by the brain and erythrocytes. Now, this happens in healthy individuals. In people with diabetes type 1, this response to hypoglycemia may be impaired by the decreased adrenergic and the glucagon secretion due to several factors. And if they have a severe insulin deficiency, prolonged fasting without insulin supply causes excessive glycogen breakdown and increased gluconeogenesis and ketogenesis, leading to hyperglycemia and ketoacidosis. Type 2 diabetics may have similar response, but the severity of disturbance will depend on the degree of insulin resistance and insulin deficiency. Therefore, taking all that into account, the main risk you would want to think about, which a diabetic patient might face during Ramadan, are hypoglycemia, hyperglycemia, ketoacidosis, dehydration, and in some occasions, thrombosis. Now, this sounds bad. I mean, does this apply to everyone with diabetes? You might argue using the pathophysiology I just described, but remember that there are many factors that play a significant role here. In fact, in some cases, fasting can even reduce the insulin resistance. So in order to determine whether it's okay to fast or not, there's now guidelines which divide diabetic patients into three categories: high risk, moderate risk, and low risk, where people in high risk category must not fast, those in the moderate risk can fast, but they had to follow a set of medical recommendations, and those in the green category are allowed to fast. And these are based on the individual risk of hypoglycemia using the risk certification tools. I'll show them briefly here on the screen, but they're based on things like whether the patient has type 1 or type 2 diabetes, whether they are unaware of the presence of hypoglycemia or not, and how often they get it, the HbA1c levels, the amount of insulin they use. Do they have any comorbidities in terms of kidney failure, episodes of ketoacidosis? You know, what are the fasting hours in the country they live in? That's also important, and so on. You use this risk stratification criteria, and then you get an overall score. If they have a score of 0 to 3, they're in the low risk category. Between 3 to 6, they're in the moderate risk. And above 6, they are in the high risk category. So some individuals with diabetes can fast, and some can't. If you've got diabetes and want to fast, I strongly recommend you to ask your local doctor for some advice before you decide to do so. So, hope that helps. You can check out the guidelines if you guys want to. Just Google it. Ramadan Kareem, everyone, and Eid Mubarak. Peace.